I'm Pat Niagara from the Ontario Coalition for Accountability. Today is June 19th and we're standing outside the Family and Children's Services annual meeting that they're having here in Welland, Ontario. And we'll be putting pamphlets on the cars along with holding some protest signs at the exit as they leave.
Three of them I found. You know, they would just love to say we do, right? Is that many of them? Across the top. There's three of them I found. You know, they would just love to say we do, right?
Right here in Welland. That very Family and Children's Services actually destroyed a man's life who offered fostering services for well over 20 years to children in Welland. And they destroyed his life.
Hey, children's aid destroys families. You can. You do it.
Oh, no help.
Say children's aid.
Children's aid
destroys families.
Good job.
Good job, buddy.
Let me see it.
Say out loud on there, I am not for sale.
Yeah, say, I am not for sale.
Say it, I am not
yell,
for sale.
Yell, I am not for sale.
I am not for sale.
You don't.
Hey, that's the boss.
Thank you.
Thank you.
See, well, the transit recognizes.
Say, I am not for sale. Say it.
Say it. I'm not for sale!
How many lives did you ruin today?
Here's your sign back, Alex.
How dare you even have an award ceremony when 107 kids died in the care of the Ontario Children's Aid last year?
You have your hands in the back pocket of the police department to tell them you will only investigate cases and allegations of abuse against foster homes or criminal activity and not allow the police to do it. Why do you continue to tell the police to keep your nose out of it, and any time a parent complains about a child being abused in a foster home, you refer it back to the Children's Aid Society? Why do you tell the police to do that? Why do you have the police continue to protect you? The Pediatric Death Review Panel has released the totals for this year, and in the year of 2012, there was 107 children that died while under the care of the Children's Aid Societies across the province of Ontario, bringing the grand total to nothing more than 720 children in the last 7 years, and that's since 2006.
How are you?
How are you?
Hello,
how's
everyone
doing?
Good.
That's right. How are you? Sorry, you guys get called out for this.
That's okay.
On ours, make sure everything's okay.
Right? Our police literature. This is what we hand out to the officers.
I'm
sure you've already seen our names in the computer when you got the call out here anyway.
No, we didn't even know. We just figured we'd stop by, say hello, and make sure everything's okay.
We know they called. They called.
Oh, no, they did call. We didn't
call. Yeah, oh, but I didn't know who exactly it is.
They just said there were some protesters.
Yeah, we used to be on.
But you're not for sale.
He's just waiting his turn to
this
haul
came
our
all
not
way
for sale.
To participate.
107 kids died in their care last year.
It's important to have a bilingual.
I'm Tim.
Hi, Tim. Pat.
Nice to meet you, Pat.
I should make friend signs, too.
Nice
to
meet Chris.
We do have a crime on videotape though of them stealing our literature that was placed on the cars before they told us not to do it.
Well,
then they went and took it all off the car.
Yeah, unfortunately it's private property, right?
Well,
but
no
they
signs
never, the thing
there.
Was they never told us not to until after we already done it. Then
they
asked us to leave, we left.
And we have video
they should have
been
actually
didn't do. If you run our names to the computer and scroll down, you'll see that audio video record all interaction.
No, this is
we, this is how we do it all the time. We've done hundreds and hundreds of these rallies, and we don't...
The function plate's actually for the children.
For the
violence.
Children died in their care last year, and not one single worker was ever held accountable for it.
My daughter was abused in foster care. This society verified it and then allowed me to call the police, and they said that the matter's been dealt with.
I have no issues.
Her just shut up and be happy.
I have no issues.
And they
I just
neither
off.
Do I. I as
ended
long
up,
as you guys
that's how my
stay
crown
here.
Ward ended up getting overturned, because after the abuse and the stink I raised about it, they returned my children, and I said, well, why are the police not involved? I'll call them myself. You know what, Kim? Don't worry about it. It's been dealt with.
You know what? It wasn't even, it wasn't Family and Children's Services that called. It was the company.
Yeah, but they called
it. Oh, yeah.
They called it the recovery.
I'm sure they expected us.
They just didn't want any issues.
No, we weren't going
to
call
the
request.
We know.
I don't know. I didn't talk to him.
We follow a very strict rally etiquette rules that Pat has developed for us. So,
anyone who appreciates it. We didn't know coming here
where
you were. So, we're just.
No, the CAS movement. That's what I'm saying.
Okay.
They do this all the time to waste you guys' time, and they know that we're harmless, and they do this all the time.
At least it's a nice day, right?
Yeah.
Yep. We've been out in the rain and the snowstorms and everything.
It don't matter to us. It's about accountability and raising awareness.
As you can see, the Niagara Regional Police were just here and things went good. They've got no issues with us being here, so we're going to continue on and wait till they come out and stand here and make sure they all know that Children's Aid destroys families.